Carlos Foundation.
Thank you. Well, just yes. trying to educate.
No, it's fantastic.
It.
Thank you. Hi, Dana.
Hello, you guys. Well, Strokes of Genius is a riveting documentary based on what is considered the greatest tennis match of all time. Joining us this morning is tennis legend Martina Navratilova and author John Wertheim. Good morning, you guys. Can you hear me? John? Martina?
Good morning.
Good morning. How
there
are you?
Are.
There you are. Okay, you, John, you wrote the book Strokes
yes,
of Genius.
Yes, we can hear you.
Okay, great. John, you wrote the book Strokes of Genius. Now it has become an 84-minute documentary. Tell us why the rivalry between Roger Federer and Rafael Nadal is one of the greatest in sports history.
Has all the classic elements of rivalry, contrast in styles, one versus two, righty-lefty. But what it also has is this warm relationship that passes between the two of them. Martina, next to me, was really the predecessor of this with Chris Evert and with Federer Nadal. They've shown to us that you can be adversaries and you don't have to be enemies. Here we are at Wimbledon. We're with Tennis Channel the next 2 weeks. And these two guys, 10 years after this match, are still 1-2, the two players to beat 10 years later.
Martina, as a Grand Slam champ, as a Grand Slam champion, tell us what goes through your mind when facing an opponent like this and everyone's watching.
Well, you're not thinking about that, really, unless something embarrassing happens, like with a shot or your skirt falls off, which happened to me in a Wimbledon final. But if you go after that, what else could go wrong? Hitting a tennis ball is easy. No, you really just think about the opponent. You think about the strategy that they probably have, most of all the strategy that you have, what works, and you really think about winning the next point. The fact that there may be millions of people watching, that's actually a bonus, but it's not something that's like, oh my goodness, all these people are watching, that's why you play tennis. Because, you know, if you hit the greatest shot in the world but nobody sees it, what's the point, right? So you want an audience, and you feed off the audience most of all on the court. The live audience is what really makes you feel the moment more than anything else. But bottom line is you just thinking about hitting the tennis ball, that's it.
Exactly. Well, Martina, compare the Roger Rafa rivalry to your own rivalry with Chris Evert Lloyd. Like, what is the same and what is different, do you think, about both of those rivalries?
I think it's very similar. Chris and I were only 2 years apart. Roger and Rafa were about 5 years apart. But still, at the height of their careers at the same time, you have the contrasting styles, contrasting personalities, perhaps maybe not as much as Chris and I had, but still, and the contrasting style also is not as obvious, but it's still a contrast, lefty against righty, and they like each other so much off the court, so I think there's so much more that's similar than what's different, really. We were both 1-2 at the same time. We played more. We played 80 times against each other on numerous exhibitions as well, so it was really hard to find anything that I could surprise Chris with and vice versa, and I think it's the same with these two guys, which is what makes it so great. They bring out the best in each other. They force each other to come up with great shots, and we are here to see it, so it's really magic, and we could have it 10 years later.
Exactly.
When John wrote this book 10 years ago, I mean, when it happened 10 years ago,
right.
The stroke of genius on his part that he actually wrote about the strokes of genius, and here we are 10 years ago, we could have the same situation.
Thank you guys so much. It was so lovely talking to you. Catch Strokes of Genius tonight right here on KTLA starting at 8 p.m. Right. Don't miss the ongoing coverage of Wimbledon through July 15th on the Tennis Channel. Great talking to you guys. Have an awesome day.
You did a very good job with that delay.
That delay
was
tough.
Like very
that
dramatic.
Delay was tough. It was really tough. It's going all the way to England,
yes.
So
yes.
It takes time.
It takes time. Well done, Dana.
Thank you.